Hi guys, my name is Neha Gupta and I'm back with the session of flashcards. So in yesterday's session, we had discussed about international and banking news. And in today's session, I will be taking up the rest of the sections, which are appointments, important days, sports, awards and miscellaneous. So without wasting any time, I'm directly discussing the first question of appointments, but do subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification so that you get the latest updates about the channel whenever we upload any kind of new video. And do not forget to subscribe to our Telegram channel, as I always say that you can connect with your mentors there and ask them your doubts and enjoy the free quizzes that we provide them. So now let's discuss the first question of the appointments for the month of September 2019. So what are the major important appointments that took place in the month of September? So firstly, we have the appointment of Hemant Khatri as the chairman and managing director of Hindustan Shipyards Limited. Now, the reason behind not going to the questions is that appointments are one-liners. And in appointments, we have only direct questions that who is dash of dash. So who is the CMD of Hindustan Shipyard Limited? It is Hemant Khatri. That's why in appointment section, we will be discussing about the appointments directly instead of going to the questions first. So our next appointment is about Usha Padhi, who has been appointed as the first woman director general of Bureau of Civil Aviation. Quite easy to remember that she, Usha, has been appointed as the first woman DG of Bureau of Civil Aviation, and she is also the joint secretary in the Ministry of Civil Aviation. Next is Murali Ramakrishnan, who has been appointed as MD and CEO of South Indian Bank, which is a private sector bank. Quite important for those who are appearing for any kind of banking examination. And next comes our news about S. Krishnan, who has been appointed as MD CEO of Punjab and Sindh Bank. Then we have Subhash Kamath, CEO of advertising agency BPH and Publicis Worldwide India. So he is already the CEO of this organization and he has been appointed as the chairman of Advertising Standards Council of India. So quite important organization it is, because it regulates the advertising standards in India. Therefore, you have to remember the chairperson of this organization. Next is Ayushman Khurana has been appointed as the celebrity advocate of UNICEF India's campaign to end violence against children. So nothing very complex here that needs any kind of explanation. It is very simple that Ayushman Khurana, who is the Bollywood actor, has been appointed the celebrity advocate. What is the celebrity advocate? Basically a kind of brand ambassador. So UNICEF's campaign to end violence against children will be promoted by Khurana in India. And Khurana has been appointed for India only. So this campaign has appointed Ayushman Khurana for promoting the campaign against violence, to end the violence against children in India only. That was all about this news. And next comes Yoshihide Suga, who has been elected as the new PM of Japan. Quite important for us to remember. This news is quite important and this requires us to pay attention to the type of question that has been framed out of this news. So firstly, let's discuss the news itself and then we will be jumping onto the question. So, India and Afghanistan have been elected as members of UN Commission on Status of Women for a four-year term beginning from 2021 to 2025. Now, this Commission on the Status of Women is a functional commission of United Nations Economic and Social Council. This United Nations Economic and Social Council has 54 member countries, and out of these 54, two are India and Afghanistan, who have recently joined. India will begin its term at UNSC's as a non-permanent member for 2021 to 2022 in January 2021. So you must be aware about India's appointment as a non-permanent member in UNSC, and India will begin its term in January 2021. So let us now see the type of question that has been framed out of this news. So which country has been elected as a member of UN Commission on the Status of Women along with India for a 4-year term beginning from 2021 to 2025? Now it is easy for you guys to answer this question, so it is Afghanistan. So you can see that merely remembering India will not work for you. You have to remember Afghanistan as well, and the details mentioned here, like how many nations are a part of UN Economic and Social Council. So these are the minute details that you need to pay attention. Next is about Anil Dhasman, who has been appointed as the chief of National Technical Research Organization, quite an important organization because it indulges in geospatial intelligence and satellite imagery. Not very important for us to remember the function of NTR. The point of importance is that the Anil Dhasman has been appointed as the chief of NTR. Do remember this thing. Next, it is again very important. RBI has appointed A.K. Dixit as the new administrator of Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank Limited. So remember this PMC bank fraud which happened in 2019, and in the wake of that fraud, in order to manage the functions of PMC, A.K. Dixit has been appointed by RBI. Then this National Medical Commission, which has recently come into existence. This was, again, I would say that it was elaborately discussed in PIB 247. Do watch that session by Manish sir, in which he has described this National Medical Commission in detail. So who is the first chairperson of this commission? It is Dr. Suresh Chandra Sharma. Quite important for us to remember. Then we have Energy Efficiency Services Limited, which has appointed Rajat Sood as its new MD. Next is RBI has appointed Amitabh Bachchan as its consumer awareness campaign to prevent account holders from being duped by fraudsters. So this question we have discussed in our morning day session. So I hope that those who are following the sessions regularly would know the answers of this question, would know the answer of this question beforehand. So that was all about this news. Next comes the PD Aguila. Has been appointed as the new chairman of Telecom Regulatory Authority of India. Again, we have discussed it in morning day session. So I hope you would not find any kind of difficulty, and it would act as a revision session for you. For those who have seen the morning days, and for those who have not seen the videos till now, don't worry, just have a look over the previous videos and do follow the morning tales on a regular basis in order to cover these current affairs in a detailed manner. So now we have the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, which has appointed Shekhar Kapoor as the new president of Film and Television Institute of India Society. Again, morning tales, we have covered it, and majority of you have also told me the answer of the question, that where is the society located, Pune, and I'm very glad about the answers that you gave me, because it gives us a sense that the students are following the current affairs and they are very well prepared in current affairs. So next comes our news, which is about total 24 parliamentary committees. Remember that we have recently covered it in our morning tales session. So these committees have been reconstituted, and the question is about the Parliamentary Committee on IT. So guys, do you remember the answer? Do tell me your answers in the comment section below. The answer is Shashi Tharoor. Then this is the same table that I took in the morning tales session as well. In this table, the important committees as well as the chairpersons are mentioned. And That's all. Our appointment section is over, and those were the most important appointments that took place in September 2020. But that's not all. We have a lot of around 30 new appointments in the month of September, but I picked up only the most important appointments for the month of September. Now, from where can you get the other appointments? From Spotlight Magazine. So you can go through the Spotlight Magazine, and remember this thing, that this session is only the revision session for Spotlight. So it is kind of the most important questions of the month of September have been picked up in this session. So do not replace or substitute this session flashcard with Spotlight Magazine. You have to go through Spotlight once for your preparation. Now, next comes our important sections section. So many students have asked me to discuss how to remember important days as well. So let me first tell you that if you are preparing for important days, then there are three things that you need to remember. First is the date of the day, or first is the name, basically the name of the day. Then we have the date, and third thing is the theme. So these are the three things that are very important for you to remember from the exam point of view. Apart from this, if any great initiative or any kind of government scheme has been launched on the special day, then you have to also remember the day, theme, and that initiative as well. Do you remember that we had discussed in the flashcard part 1, we had discussed about the Padhna Likhna Abhiyan. So this Padhna Likhna Abhiyan was launched on the International Literacy Day. So when is this International Literacy Day observed? That you have to tell me in the comment section below. But this initiative is very important, as well as International Literacy Day is also very important, because this government initiative by Ministry of Education was launched on International Literacy Day. And do not forget to mention your answers in the comment section, that when is this day observed. Now we have discussed many things, and it's time for us to quickly discuss the news. So we have the first question here about the theme of World Coconut Day. So I have told you date, day and theme. So here the question is from the theme. So what is the theme of Coconut Day? It is invest in coconut to save the world. Then we have the next question, which is about the very first International Day of Clean Air for Blue Skies, which is observed on September 7, 2020. And the question is from the date itself, that when is this day observed? Why the date is being asked? The reason is that it is the first ever day, first ever International Day. Now we have the theme of this day, which is Clean Air for All. Then we have this International Literacy Day, as I have told you, and this day is observed on September 8. The theme is Literacy Teaching and Learning in the COVID-19 Crisis and Beyond. So quite easy for us to remember. Now we have certain facts about India's literacy rate. So these facts were released by NSO, that is National Statistical Office. So NSO has released the 75th round of its National Statistical Survey, and as part of that survey, which was released in December 2019, these facts were presented. So these facts, I have taken these facts from that report only, in order to give you a glance, give you an overview of India's literacy. So let's go through the numbers quickly. So we have India's total literacy rate at 77.7%. Most literate state, we know it is Kerala, then we have Delhi. Least literate state is Andhra Pradesh. Rural areas literacy rate is 73.5%. Then urban areas literacy rate is 87.7%. Then we have male literacy rate at 84.7%. Females at 70.3%. And Kerala's male literacy rate is 97.4% as compared to 95.2% literacy rate among women. Why we have taken this Kerala? What is so special about Kerala? The reason is that it has the highest literacy rate in India. Therefore, we should know that how much percentage of males and females are literate in the state of Kerala. That is why we have taken up this state. Now let's have a glance over the type of questions that have been asked in this news. First, we have the date of International Literacy Day, that is September 8, I have already told you. And next is our urban area literacy rate. So what is the urban area literacy rate? It is 87.7%, that is option B. Next question is, first ever International Day to Protect Education from Attack. It was celebrated by United Nations on September 9th. So we have been asked about the date of this day. So it is here. Now what is the theme of this day? The theme is Protect Education, Save a Generation. Quite easy to remember. If we are protecting education from attack, then the theme would be obviously this Protect Education, Save a World. Next is National Engineers Day. So India observes this day on September 15 to honor the eminent engineer. So this engineer, Vishwesvarya, is also India's first civil engineer and also known as the father of Indian engineering. That is why this day is very important. So he was the first civil engineer and father of Indian engineering. Now let's see what kind of question has been picked up from this news. On whose birthday does India observe National Engineers Day? Quite a tricky question. So, actually not tricky, it is twisted because the date is not asked directly. It is twisted and the person who on whose birthday this day is celebrated has been asked here. So, what is our answer? It is M. Vishwesvarya. Option B. Then we have Ozone Day, World Ozone Day, September 16th. Theme is Ozone for Life, 35 years of ozone layer protection. So we clearly know that what is the answer of this question. Now what is this 35 years of ozone layer protection? So the reason behind this theme is that 2020 marks the 35 years of Vienna Convention for the Protection of Ozone Layer, which was signed in the year 1985. So this year, 2020 marks the 35th anniversary of Vienna Convention. That's why the theme also mentions 35 years of ozone protection. So in this manner, you can easily remember these two statements, the theme as well as the reason behind the theme and the Vienna Conventions launch date or the signing year. Then we have another protocol, another convention for protecting ozone. And what is that convention? It is Montreal Convention in 1987, which set the target of reducing all ozone depleting substances by 99%. So basically negating all the ozone depleting elements from the earth. Then we have Kigali Amendment to Montreal Protocol, which came into effect in 2019. So this is the very recent amendment. This is very recent and there are high chances that this can be asked in the examination. So what is this Kigali Amendment to Montreal Protocol? So this Kigali Amendment includes the hydrofluorocarbons and greenhouse gases. So this Kigali Amendment aims to reduce hydrofluorocarbon and greenhouse gases emissions in order to protect ozone layer. So these three international conventions are quite important for you to know and to remember from the exam point of view. Now let's have a look on our next question, which is about the first ever International Equal Pay Day that is observed on September 18 by UN to promote equal pay for both men and women for the work of equal value. Now, why is this day being observed? What is the importance of this day? So, in the entire globe, a majority of women do not get their equal share of payment, their equal share of profit or income for the same kind of work that their male counterparts do. And in India, we have 19% of women which earn less than their male counterparts for the same kind of work. So that is why, in order to promote that equal pay among men and women, this day is being observed. So let's have a look at the question now. So the question is clearly asking us about the date. So the date is September 18th. Next is our day on International Coastal Cleanup Day. Quite easy to remember, the purpose of this day is to promote cleanliness on India's coast. Not on India's coast, but on the coastal areas worldwide. So this day is observed on 3rd September in third Saturday in September. And in 2020, this day lies on September 19th. Then the theme is Achieving a Trash-Free Coastline. What is the theme of this day? This is the theme, Achieving a Trash-Free Coastline. Now, we have quite important things to cover in this day, because on this day only Ministry of Environment recommended a total number of 8 beaches. So these 8 beaches were recommended for Blue Flag certification. What is this Blue Flag certification? This certification is the world, is the globally acknowledged certification for the world's most clean beaches. So how many beaches have been recommended? 8. And Blue Flag certification is given by Foundation for Environmental Education, which is based in Denmark. So a question might come up from here also, that where is this Foundation for Environment Education based, or which organization accredits or renders the Blue Flag certification. So these are very important details that you need to pay attention to. Now the next thing of importance that India did on this day is India launched its own certification system, which is named as BEAMS. What is the full form of BEAMS? Beach Environment and Aesthetics Management Services. So BEAMS is India's own certification, like the Blue Flag certification. So do remember this thing as well. This is very important. And also remember the full form of BEAMS, because it can also be asked in the exam. Now let's have a look at the type of questions. Now the next question from this news only is, what is the name of India's own eco label for maintaining cleanliness of beaches and promoting sustainable development of marine ecosystem? So the answer is BEAMS. We already have discussed this thing. And now we will quickly be moving on to our next question, which is World Maritime Day, September 24th. Theme is Sustainable Shipping for a Sustainable Planet. Quite easy to remember. And the question is about the date. Then we have World Tourism Day, September 27th. Then theme is Tourism and Rural Development. Quite important. Why? Because the United Nations World Tourism Organization has designated 2020 as the year of tourism and rural development. So that is why this day is important. The theme is very important. And now let's have a look at the type of question that has been asked from this news. What is the theme of World Tourism Day 2020? Clearly, rural and tourism and rural development. So this is the question from Tourism Day. Then our next question, or the last question from the important days section. So the first edition of International Day of Awareness on Food Loss and Wastage Reduction. Do you remember? We have covered it in morning days. So I hope that majority of my students would already know the answer of this question. So let's quickly have a look at the news. So this day is observed on 29 September by UN. Theme is Stop Food Loss and Waste for the People, for the Planet. And in this news, in this pointer, it is mentioned that Food and Agriculture Organization has created the Food Loss Index to monitor SDG 12.3. So what is this SDG 12.3? SDG 12.3 focuses on reducing food loss and food waste. So in order to monitor the progress of different nations on the SDG target 12.3, this FAO, which is a part of United Nations, has launched this food loss index. So do remember this thing as well. And this point we had discussed it in our session, that globally 14% of food is lost between post-harvest and final consumption state. And that is why this day is being observed, in order to create awareness among the people to reduce this food waste and loss. And here this important day section has ended, and we have come to the next section, which is awards. So first news is Venus Film Festival Award, and we had already discussed this question also in one of our morning days. So let's quickly discuss the type of question that has been asked from this news. So which Indian director has won the Venice Film Festival 2020 award is the award for best screenplay category. So which Indian it is? It is Chaitanya Tamhani. So Chaitanya has won this award for best screenplay for his movie The Disciple. Quite important for us to remember the details as well, because it is an Indian which has won this award. So do remember the details. Now guys, this Venice Film Festival Awards has been presented in quite a different category. So there are various categories under which Venice Film Festival Award is presented. For example, award for best screenplay, Coppa Volpi for best actress, best actor, and similarly in various other categories as well. Now what I have done is that I have put only the most important categories which are very relevant for the examination. So I have put those categories only in spotlight as well as in flashcard. So if you want to have a look at the entire list of awards, you can go through the link which is mentioned in Spotlight magazine. But I would advise you to stick to the material that has been provided to you, because that has been provided after quite a research. Okay, so then we have the next question from the awards itself. So European Awards of Excellence 2020. These awards have been announced, and Aditya Puri has got Lifetime Achievement Award, and he is the MD of HDFC Bank. Now recently HDFC Bank's new MD has been appointed, and you have to tell me in the comment section that who is the new MD of HDFC Bank. So now let's have a look at the different categories of awards under the Euromoney Awards of Excellence 2020. So globally, world's best bank is JP Morgan, world's best investment bank, Goldman Sachs. Then we have Global Excellence in Leadership, HSBC CEO Myaul Quinn, and Credit Suisse CEO Thomas Gottstein. So these two CEOs have got this Global Excellence in Leadership Award. Then we have Banker of the Year, Brian Moynihan, who is from Bank of America. Asia's best bank is DBS Singapore. Asia's best investment bank is Citi. Okay, so the categories have ended now. Let's have a look at the type of questions that have been asked from this news. Which bank has won the Asia's Best Bank Award at Euromoney Awards of Excellence 2020? So we have just discussed the Asia's Best Bank, which is DBS Singapore. And the next question is, who has won the Lifetime Achievement Award? It is Aditya Puri, the ex-CEO of HDFC Bank. Do remember this thing, that the new CEO or MD of HDFC Bank will take his position on October 27. So till that time, Aditya Puri is the recent HDFC Bank MD. Okay, then we also have a third question from this news only. So which of the following has won the world's best bank award at Euromoney Awards of Excellence? It is JP Morgan. And this is our third question from award section. US has nominated Udit Singhal from India as a part of 2020 class of young leaders for SDGs, which comprise a total number of 17 young leaders, including Singhal, from across the globe. Now, what is the purpose of this UN class of young leaders for SDGs? these young leaders promote SDGs, Sustainable Development Goals, in their own respective countries. And Udit Singhal has been appointed from India, and he has been chosen because of his initiative, which is Glass to Sand. Under this initiative, Udit Singhal has always tried to reduce the waste production, glass waste production, to zero. So this is the initiative for which Singhal has been appointed. And question is also asking about the name of which Indian. So which Indian is it? It is Udit Singhal. Then we have the next award, which is United Nations Interagency Task Force Award, for its, which has been won by Kerala for its outstanding performance on those sustainable development goals which are focused on controlling non-communicable diseases. Do remember the purpose as well, that Kerala has won this award for controlling non-communicable diseases, for working on those SDGs that focus on controlling non-communicable diseases. Then we have the last question from the award section. Now you must be thinking that there are only 5 questions from the entire month of September. Yes, awards were less in the month of September, but only the most important awards have been picked up here by me, so that you know the most important awards at a glance. As I have already mentioned this thing to you in the very first session of flashcards, that these flashcards are not to substitute spotlight. These are just the last minute revision for you guys. So from that perspective, I have only picked up the most important awards here. So this award is All India Football Federation's annual award for 2019 to 2020, and Sanju Yadav and Gurpreet Singh Sandhu have won the Players of the Year award. And here ends our section of awards, and we will be discussing the sports section next. So in this sports section, US Open, quite an important tournament that has held recently. So Dominic Thiem, who is from Austria, and Naomi Osaka, who is from Japan, have won this US Open in men's and women's categories respectively. And the question is also about the women's single winner. Next is the Tour de France. So this is a cycling tournament that happens in France every year. And who has won this tournament this year? It is this. Then comes our Rome Masters or Italian Open. It is again a tennis tournament. Quite important from the exam point of view. So who has won it in the men's single category? Novak Djokovic in men's and Simona Halep in women's category. And that is all from the sports section. Again, I would say that sports were limited in September. We all know that COVID has halted majority of sports tournament in 2020. Therefore, there were only a limited number of sports tournaments that were held in September. And out of those limited tournaments, I have picked up the most important tournaments for the session here. This is the section miscellaneous, in which books and the diseased personalities are mentioned most prominently. Now you would be thinking, why to study the diseased people who have already died? The purpose is because nowadays questions have been asked on the most prominent personalities. The questions are on the nationality of the person who has recently died. If that person is of great stature, then the sport, the profession of that person. If he is a sports person, and if yes, then which sport? And if he is a literary person or journalist, etc., then the nationality, sports, and any kind of prominent thing that the person has done. So these types of questions have been asked in the examination quite a long period of time. Therefore, we need to study the diseased personalities as well and books. So, the first question is about Romila Thapar's Voices of Dissent book. Romila Thapar is a very prominent historian and she has released this Voices of Dissent. Therefore, this book is very important from the exam point of view. And the question is about the author itself. Then we have former Australian batsman Dean Jones, who has passed away. Remember that I have taken up this question in the session as well, in morning days. So, the question is about the nationality of Dean Jones. Then in the third news, we have US President Barack Obama's memoir, So A Promised Land. And the question is that whose memoir is titled as A Promised Land? So, it is Barack Obama. Then we have Govind Swarup, who is also known as the father of Indian radio astronomy. So the question is, who is known as the father of Indian radio astronomy? It is Govind Swarup. So as I have already told you in the beginning of this section that the deceased persons are very important for you to remember. So don't ignore them by thinking that they have died and they are not of relevance. They are of relevance. Do remember these things that I am mentioning in this session continuously. And here comes our session to an end. I hope that you have liked the flashcard sessions that I am providing. And these sessions would help you in understanding and remembering the current affairs for the month of September 2020. And thank you so much for watching this video till the end. And if you have liked this session, then do subscribe to our channel and hit the like button as well. Thank you.